We're here with Rob Smith tonight. We'll visit with Jody Germanic about Bobcats softball and Frank Solich coming up, too. So it's year three, and the building blocks are hopefully in place. Let's talk about those and getting the culture right. Do you feel that those pieces, how you want to have your program, are you further along in year three than you were in year one?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I mean, I think that's all part of building a program is you have to change the culture. You have to get it to, you know, the mindset of the players where you want it, get them, you know, to learn how to practice, how you want to practice. And then I think some of that also, too, comes through recruiting, you know, and you identify the types of people that you want to put in place. And, you know, we've been able to do that now, a couple of recruiting classes in. Those guys have now been exposed, you know, going into year three. And I think what you're seeing this year is just a much better understanding of what we're trying to do and a lot more cohesiveness up and down from players to coaches and everybody involved in the program.
How can you ensure, hopefully, and there's nothing that you can ensure, but how do you make sure that you give yourself the best chance for this to continue throughout the course of the year?
Well, you know, hitting can be certainly interesting that way, as is scoring. And we've seen in some games when you run into a good pitcher that it can become a real challenge to score some runs. But I think the biggest thing for us is just to continue to stay healthy. So when you keep certain pieces healthy and you keep everybody moving in the right direction, it gives you a much better chance to be successful.
Ohio University softball was in the NCAA tournament last year, and it was really cool to be around them for a couple of games. And hopefully the Bobcats will be back in the NCAA tournament with not too much of a delay. The Cats are 9-18 right now, 2-0 in conference play. How about a nice round of applause for Jody Germanic, the head coach of Bobcat softball. Hi, Coach. How are you?
Good. I'm good.
You played really well in Kalamazoo, and you got two done there. And yes. How were you able to pull it out so late, both games?
I wish I had the magic answer for that, because it's just honestly not something in our pre-conference season that we've really seen a lot of comebacks from this team right now. And the second part of the season and the new part of our journey of how we're going to take on a different mindset and get new outcomes. And so I was so proud of the team to just watch them kind of calm down, settle down, not look at the game as seven runs and just really take it inning by inning. And then the second game, you know, it was just a great job by us just to scrap them out and get them when they counted. We had a lot of timely hitting this weekend, and that was something that was awesome for this group to have.
Have you been to the Kibbe Dome before, Frank Solich?
No, this will be my first time.
Well, it's something. And you'll visit the Vandals coming up to open up the season. How about a nice round of applause for your soon-to-be 11th-year head coach? Well, he is, of Bobcat football, Frank Solich. How have you been?
Been good. Been good.
Doing, you know, well?
Yeah, yeah.
How's the spring been for you?
It's been good. You know, we've gotten great use out of the indoor. That's been a tremendous asset for us.
When you take a look at spring ball, in your bullet points as a head coach, what do you hope to accomplish within the spring?
Well, you want to give everybody some reps that's on your football team. So the players know that this is their opportunity to work their way up on the depth chart. And the only way to give a guy a fair shot at that is to make sure that everybody gets a decent amount of reps. So we start off by giving everybody reps. But obviously, we are really working at not only refining our starting unit, but really working at getting some depth by getting those guys reps and having them come along at a high rate.
You now can follow Frank Solich on Twitter, which is really an amazing thing. Are you composing tweets? Are there rough drafts here? Are you how involved in Twitter is Frank Solich going to be?
I'm working at it. Okay. We'll see how it works out.
To things of more pressing nature, your thoughts on the state of the program right now?
Well, we want to continue to move the program forward. There are still steps to take, and you know, we kind of got in neutral here this past year, but obviously we're all pointing towards having a better year, having a great year. And, you know, we were fairly inexperienced last year. So I think that did show at times. So we'll be a more experienced group as we take the field this year. But all in all, I like the attitude of our players. We've got talent on our football team. I think these last 2 years have been the best recruiting years that we have had since our staff has been at Ohio, so I think that'll mean an awful lot. I think there's some really good football to be played down the road here.
Well, good luck with that, and good luck navigating the Twitter waters.
Thanks.
And our next network broadcast will be your first coach's show of 2015, and we look forward to that. Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
And we look forward to covering the spring sports the rest of the ride. We'll be back with you with the Frank Solid Show coming up in the fall. That'll put the wraps on our final coach's show of the year from Ohio's campus at Baker Center. I'm Russ Eisenstein. So long from Athens. This is the Ohio IMG Sports Network.